I'm Hans Kandel, Extension Agronomist with NDSU. Over the last couple of years, we have done a large survey among growers to ask them about their production practices. This one was over a period of 4 years and it involved over 1,000 producer fields. We analyzed the data and asked farmers, when did you plant? How much seed did you use? What variety did you use? What kind of yield did you get? And several other factors. The main points that we learned is that if you collectively looked at the planting date is very crucial in the yield potential of the crop. Just by planting 1 day later, when the season is ready, can give you a reduction in yield of about 0.3 bushels per acre based on this large data set. The second point that we found is the selection of the maturity of the varieties. The maturity is very critical. We need to get a variety that is as long as possible without hitting the frost date in the fall. But if we can go 1/10 of a point in maturity higher, we will pick up about 0.7 bushels per acre based on this large survey. The third factor is seeding rate. Farmers are using various seeding rates and we looked at the seeding rate, and if we are getting about 150,000 plants established in the farm, we will maximize yield. However, if you plant a little bit higher seeding rate, we do see a yield response. We ask ourselves, is this economic or not? And that is another question. We are looking now at the yield response to seeding rate. So based on some of those factors, we decided that we will test this one out in some of our small plots. This particular trial that I'm standing in front of has been replicated in about 7 locations throughout parts of North Dakota, and that was in 2019, and it is replicated again in 2020. In this particular trial, we have 3 factors. We have planting date, the optimum date, as soon as we can get into the field in the spring, 2 weeks later. We have 2 row spacings, the narrow row spacing, 12 inches, and the wide row spacing, 24 inches, and seeding rate. Then we selected 2 varieties that were about 2 or 3 points difference in maturity. So we have here what we call a factorial, looking at the various factors that influence the productivity of this particular field. In the last year, we found that if you planted the later maturing, yes, we got a higher yield. If we planted with more seeds, we got more yields. We also know that the row spacing is important, and typically we find that a narrow row spacing, 12 inches, will yield more than the 24 inch. However, our question is there a synergy between all those factors? So in the trial behind me, we have combined all those factors so that we can check out the various factors that are involved. In this particular trial is the 24 inch row spacing with the late maturing variety, and it has a bit of a yellow color. And the next plot over, we have a smaller row spacing, the 12 inch row spacing. And as you can see, the color is slightly more gray. We are looking here at the combination of the early maturity and the late maturing. This one is the early maturing, but this one was planted late. The plots in front of us here are the early planted variety with 12 inch row spacing, and it is the early maturing variety. On the other side, we have the wider row spacing, the same variety, also early planted. So the difference between the two is, if you look here into the row, you can see there is a wide area between the two rows. We are talking about solar radiation as the driving force for yield. So during the earlier part of the season, I used an app called Canopio, and I took a picture above the canopy when it was green, and we calculated the green area of this plot versus the green area of the narrow row spacing. And every time we do this, we come to the conclusion that the narrow row spacing covers the ground more quickly and more solar radiation is intercepted early in the season. And as the solar radiation is driving the yield, we typically get higher yields with the narrow row spacing compared to the wide row spacing. So based on the research that we have been conducting in 2019, we found that there is indeed a synergy. The best combination is planting early, as soon as you can in the spring, planting a later maturing variety, and planting narrow row spacing, and with a high seeding rate. This one was planted with 185,000 seeds. It was planted as soon as we could in the spring, about 15th of May. And this is an early maturing variety, or a late maturing, an 0.8 maturing variety. And as you see, it is the narrow row spacing with 12 inches. So out of the trial that we conducted, we did find that if you can combine those factors and put them all together, we are out yielding and are able to obtain the best results for our farm. So early planting, the best maturity for your region, a good seeding rate, get at least 150,000 plants per acre, and plant narrower than the 30 inch, preferably in that range of 12 to 14 inch. That one will be the combination where you obtain the highest yield.